What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to another Digital Altar tutorial video. Today we are jumping into one of my favorite pieces of artwork and one of my favorite cards, honestly, and that's Armageddon with the Chris Ran artwork that came out quite a while ago. We're using the Masters 25 edition as a base, and we're going to be moving on from there with some of the text from a previous version. So let's go ahead, let's jump right in and get to it. All right, guys, so we are here with this beautiful, beautiful Chris Ran art. I absolutely love this. I mean, the colors in this artwork are just spectacular, so we're gonna take our time and highlight that today. We've got the same process. If you've looked at some of our other tutorial videos, it's a very similar process to what we are gonna be doing today. The only trick is we've got a couple of little factors, and you'll notice this as we go through, that do have to change, and so we'll go through that as we do this, but of course, the first place we're gonna be starting is the frames, so let's go ahead and jump into that. As always, guys, we are going to start by fixing these little bumps. This is one of the easiest things, but I love doing this. It's just very satisfying for some reason. Use that rectangular selection tool, grab a little bit of a sample from the above image and just drag it over top. And then, of course, go ahead, mask that out. And then as we come down to where essentially the new artwork meets the old artwork, we're going to take a very, very soft brush and just very quickly glide over those. That just cleans up that transition, really feathers that edge, so that way it really makes it nice and smooth and absolutely beautiful. Now, I know the artwork looks terrible at the moment, but we're going to be fixing that next. The first thing here is really to merge these layers down, actually. So let's go ahead, let's merge these two. Now we've got essentially one piece of artwork here versus a multi-layer piece. And then ideally we just need to select out the center of this artwork. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna try and take care of all the little edges here as we do this. That actually wasn't the greatest selection. So let's try one more time here. Let's do just like that. That looks pretty good. We'll go ahead and mask that out, and obviously this is not what we want, so if we hit invert, we get exactly what we need, which is that beautiful frame around the edge. Okay, now the next step is the really fun part, which is just dragging in the new artwork. We do, of course, have to fix this little edge on the frame as well around that foil stamp, and we'll do that after the artwork is already there. That way we can really see the contrast between the two. Okay, so step one, drag in that new artwork and look at this. The next step is really just to size it up. You do want to make sure that if you're following along, or if you happen to be creating proxies of your own, that you're using as high res as you can possibly get. It's really important to not have a very fuzzy image. You lose a lot of that clarity there that you do not want to lose. Now, I'm just gonna very quickly kind of mess around with the composition here. There's a lot of really beautiful lines in this artwork. You can certainly test this as you see fit. I personally really want to have this nice sweeping line here. And I actually kind of like where we're at here. This balances out quite nicely with the foreground element here and then that beautiful sky element there. So we're gonna keep that. Now, make sure, again, we don't want to forget about that little foil stamping at the very bottom. So we're gonna take our brush tool. We're gonna make sure that hardness is all the way up, so we've got that nice hard edge on it. Shrink it down a little bit and make sure white is your foreground color. We're editing the mask itself here, so we just want to make sure that we are not deleting anything out. And you'll notice it's actually a little hard to tell where that line ends. So if we zoom in just a little bit, again, kind of tricky. You can use your best judgment here. I am going to take just a little bit here. There we go. And then we'll see if we can get this out here. I'm getting a little bit of an odd colored edge here. Hopefully that's not super noticeable after the fact, but we'll look at that and we'll fix it as necessary. Overall though, not too bad. Now the line here is not perfect. We can certainly fix that up as we see fit. And what I'm going to do is actually go back to that black brush and just very, very subtly kind of finagle this line around. Make sure that it's exactly where you want it. If you're following around with what we're doing, and just get it roughly where you want it. Thankfully, it's not super noticeable, but still not super happy with it, if I'm honest. But we'll come back and we'll fix that in post. Okay, so we have got the frame in place, we've got the artwork in place. Again, we'll fix some of that little framing issue in after the fact here so as not to take this too long, but the next step is actually going to be to get the text in here. I love having the text over the image. It still makes the card functional, but it also just looks absolutely beautiful. So let's go ahead and do that now. So because the initial text for this artwork actually has the times or the magic symbol behind it, it does make it a little bit trickier to select out. So what we're going to do is utilize one of the older printings of this card with a beautiful quote here as well. And we're going to take the text from this. So to do that, we actually can just use the rectangular selection tool here since we don't have too much else that we need to pull out. And just mask that out. Now, I always like to use the color range tool for this part. It just makes it very easy. You can select the shadows, which is obviously just going to be the darkest part of the image. And for us, that's been masked out to be just the wording, which is great. It makes it really nice and easy. Just play around with this. You can use this little preview pane to kind of see exactly what you are going to be selecting. It also does update it here for you. And that's exactly what we want. Now, looks terrible at the moment, I know. What we're gonna do, as always, is color overlay white on top of that. And what this does is it just adds that little bit of contrast. Now, I also really like to add a drop shadow to the text. It's very subtle, especially in artwork where you've got a very dark background. It's not doing too much, but it does, if you look at the card closely, it does help the text stand out just a bit. Now, one thing you could very easily do, and we're going to play around with it just a little bit here, is kind of center up the text a little. Again, I really like highlighting the actual artwork itself. I also really am a stickler for having even spacing on either side here. And while I know the original card did not have that, I think that this looks a little cleaner in my opinion. All right, and at this point, that's the entire altar. Obviously, there's a little bit of cleanup in that bottom corner or the foil stamping to fix, but other than that, I really, really like this. Chris Rand did an amazing job with this beautiful artwork. Thank you for the support on this series, guys. I really do appreciate it. It's been really fun doing these little tutorial videos for individual cards. Obviously, as always, if you guys have a particular proxy that you'd like to see or an idea for a different kind of frame, I do want to kind of jump into some different stuff, and that way it's not always the same frame. Please let me know. I'd love to see what your thoughts are and maybe hopefully create a video specifically for you guys. But I do appreciate it, guys. Thank you so much, and I will see you in the next Digital Altar tutorial.